Welcome. This video will walk you through how to register for Rock Valley College classes via the online services system. You'll begin by going to Rock Valley College's homepage, which is www.rockvalleycollege.edu. And then you can click on My RVC in the top yellow bar. My RVC has great links to access all of your student information and course information through RVC Eagle, your student email, Engage via Student Life, your RVC Alerts and Important Dates links, the College Catalog and Student Handbook, along with Password Management and our Faculty and Staff Directory. For now, we'll focus on online services. When you're brought to online services, you can click on Log In, and then you can enter your student ID number and password. Make sure to use a lowercase s for this system. And click Submit. Now you can click on Student. And you'll be brought to your student menu within online services. To register for classes, you'll click on the second link under registration, which is Register for Sections. And then you can click on Search and Register for Sections. At this point, before seeing the screen that you see now, you may be asked to update your personal information, which you should go ahead and do. And then you may also be asked to sign our annual disclosure for RVC's Drug-Free Schools and Communities Amendment Act. And then you'll be brought to our Search and Register for Sections screen. We're currently approaching registration for Fall Credit 2020, as well as our Summer 1 and Summer 2 sessions. For now, we'll look at Fall Credit 2020. And we'll search for a few common classes. We'll look for English to start. So you can either scroll down or you can start typing and the subject area will come up. And if you know a course number, you can enter that, which we'll look at English 101. If you don't know what specific course number you want, you can leave that blank. And we'll look up Psychology 170. And Student Development, 100. At this point, you can limit your search further by certain days of the week that you're available, as well as by location, such as RVC Mulford, if you would like to only stay at the main campus. So RVC Mulford Road. Or if you're looking for online only, you can also select online here. I typically encourage my students to leave them all blank to see all of your available options and click Submit. Now you'll be brought to all of the sections that are available. So this will show you the semester you're looking at. If the class is open, that means there are available seats to register for. This is the class with section information, and if you want more information about a specific course, you can click on this link and you'll be redirected to additional section information, including the course description and any special comments and instructor information. You'll see the location of the course, so this happens to be on main campus. It'll show you the dates that the course runs. This is a full term course that runs Mondays and Wednesdays from 7:30 in the morning to 8:45 in the morning, Classroom Building 1. Here's your instructor information, and then the first number you see is the number of seats currently available to register for. The middle number shows you the number of total seats in the classroom, and the final number shows you the number of people on the wait list. And the final column will show you how many credits the class is worth. So we'll select the first one just to make it simple. So you'll see these check boxes. You pick the one that corresponds best with your schedule. Scroll down and we should see Psychology pop up eventually. No, before I show you that though. Towards the bottom is where all your online sections will be grouped together, as well as your hybrid sections. So hybrid sections typically start with an H, our evening sections with an E, and our daytime sections with a D. Internet with an I. So you'll see those grouped at the bottom. Moving on to Psych 170. Same information. We'll do a Tuesday, Thursday at 9 for the sake of it. And then STU 100 towards the bottom. I'm going to pick another section that I think works with this schedule. And there, now we've selected our three classes we're looking for fall semester. And now we can hit submit. And this will bring you to your register and drop section screen. And it'll show you a list of all the preferred sections. For this individual here, you'll see there are still some fall credit 2017 and summer session 2017 things here. So your preferred sections will save here forever. At this time, since it's been several years now, we will remove from the waitlist these four courses. And if registration had already been open for fall credit, then we'd be able to register at this time. But for now, we will leave them blank since they won't process for registration quite yet. Open registration for summer starts March 24th at 9 p.m. And priority registration for fall starts April 5th at 9 p.m. And open registration begins April 8th at 9 p.m. So you can come in to this system, build your preferred list, and then return when you're ready to register. It'll save you some time and to make sure you can get the seats you want when you want them. So what we're going to do is hit submit and remove these four. So it'll show you what has just been processed and you're not currently registered for anything yet. And it'll also show you any waitlisted courses. And we're just going to hit OK. It's going to throw us back to searching and registering for sections, but we're going to actually click on student menu. So say you built your preferred list and now it's open registration and you want to pick those courses and actually put them on your schedule. You can log right back into online services and then click on register and drop sections this time. And it'll bring you right back to that screen where we have all of these classes sitting here. So you can add multiple sections if you're trying to weigh which one might work better for your schedule at a certain point in time, and then on registration, come in and click register for the specific sections that you'd actually like to put on your course schedule. So you'll see any red errors come up if for some reason it can't be scheduled. Right now, it's not quite open registration time for fall semester, so that's why they didn't process. If they had processed, you would see that your current registrations now include those three classes. Going back to the student menu, if you're unsure, you want to triple check that your schedule went through, you can come down to your academic profile and click on My Class Schedule and Textbook List and select the term you just registered for, which would be Fall Credit 2020, and click Submit. And at this time, you should see the courses you registered for, as well as a button to click for textbooks that will automatically generate your textbook list. Returning to the student menu, you can also go in to view your account and make payments. And this is also where you can set up a payment plan for those specific courses as well. We hope this has helped you register. If you need additional help, please contact us.